Hello students, welcome to your online lectures back. After a short break, I hope you all were at home revising whatever we had taught you during the previous 1 month. We had already started in English. We had already started with our syllabus. Okay, we had finished the first chapter. And today we are going to go ahead with the syllabus and learn new things. Okay. Can you see these two pictures over here? Okay, what is it? What does it show? Do you remember anything that we had studied during the activity? The last chapter, also the first chapter that we had studied, was also about the opposite words, right? We had studied about two stories, right? And this time also, we are going to study two stories, which in a way represents the antonyms or the opposite words. Over here, they have given you two opposite words, that is outside and inside. You can see in this picture that the cat, okay, is outside the box, and in the second picture, the cat is inside the box. Okay, in a similar way, there's some similarity of the second chapter that we are going to study today. So, what are the learning objectives today? Again, we are going to study about opposite words. Okay, and there's a story which is related to the opposite word. We will read the chapter. We are going to learn new words today again and also learn how to pronounce and the meanings. And we are going to also solve few question answers and the grammar part which is related to the topic or to the chapter today. So, today we are going to start with the second chapter, and the name of the chapter is Inside and Outside. What do Mia and her mother see in the house? Okay, over here in the picture, you can see there's a small girl. Her name is Mia, and there is her mother. Okay, and both of them have, seen something in the house. So we are going to study what they have come across, what they have seen in their house. Please read along with me. Please, see the video again and again and try to understand and read and pronounce the word correctly. Mia, what are these? Mother, they are ants. They are looking for food. Okay, so you can see over here black color ants over there on the floor. Okay, and you can see that they are in the straight line. So Mia is looking at the ants and she's asking her mom that what is this? What is there on the floor? Which is, going in a line. Her mother replies saying that these are ants. Okay, they are ants. And what are they doing in the house? They're looking for food. I am pretty much sure you all also must have seen ants. Okay, they come in the house looking for food and they always are in search of something sweet. If you drop, say, sugar or crumbs of biscuits or anything, if you do not clean that particular, spot, or that part, then you can see that immediately these ants will come, okay, because they are attracted to sweetness. Okay, so Mia's mom over here is saying that the ants have come in the house and they're looking for food, okay, and that's why you should never eat something which will fall on the floor of the house. Otherwise, the ants will come and they'll bite you. So be careful from next time. Always keep a plate or something like that, or sweep or mop. I'm sure your mom does it, but you need to be very careful and help your mom in that way. The second story over here is what do Karan and his father see in the garden? Okay, so over here you can see Karan over here is a small boy and he's come with his father, okay, outside. They are not in the house. Mia and her mother were inside the house. Karan and his father, they're not in the house, they're outside the house, and we need to see what they are doing. So let us read now. Karan, what are these? Father, they are bees. They are making honey. So over here you can see bees, okay, you can see honeybees over here. And what they do is they make honey. Honey is called in Hindi shahad. Okay, and how do they make honey? the honey bees. Okay, the bees, they suck the nectar, that is a sweet part, okay, from the flower, and they collect it and they come back to their house, the honeycomb. Okay, and that's how they make the honey. Okay, so Karan is looking at the honeycomb. He does not know what exactly it is. So his father replies and says that it is a honeycomb. They are the bees, and what are they doing? They are making what? Honey. Okay. Let us quickly revise the chapter. The name of the chapter is Inside and Outside, and there is these two stories, which has been given over here, which shows about people being inside the house and people being outside the house, and what do they see? Okay, being in their respective places. First story was about Mia and her mother. And Mia is asking her mother that what is there on the floor of the house, because she can see the parade of ants. And her mother replies that they are ants on the floor, and what are they doing in the house? They are looking for food. Whereas on the in the second story, we saw Karan and his father. Both of them are outside the house, and they are visiting a garden. Okay, and over there Karan sees a honeycomb, and he's asking questions to his father that what it is, and his father is patiently, replying, saying that it is a honeycomb, and there are bees near the honeycomb, and they are making what? Honey. Okay, so these were the two stories that we studied about. So now we are going to start and solve the question and answers and the grammar part related to it. Please write down, okay, of all the question and answers that will come henceforth from this, slide. Let's read and find facts. First one, choose the right word, then read the sentence. First one, the A one is Mia and her mother are in the house or garden. Where was Mia and her mom? They were in the house, so you will put a tick mark on house. Second one, Karan and his father are inside or outside the house. They both of them are where? Outside the house, okay? They're in the playground. Okay, they are somewhere outside. So you'll put a tick mark on outside. Second, choose the right answer. Mia's mother says the ants are in the house because it is raining outside. They are looking food. Okay, so over here you have to, take one of the option. They're asking whether the ant came in Mia's house because it was raining outside. They did not have umbrella or raincoat to wear. That's why they were, they came inside the house. Or were they looking for food? The answer is they were looking for food. So put a tick on the second option. B1, Karan's father says the bees are making honey. Second is making noise. Okay. Were they making noise or were they making honey? So the answer is they were making honey. Who was making honey? The honey bees were making honey. So put a tick mark on making honey. Let's read between the lines. The first question, what are come in Mia's house? Answer is ants have come in Mia's house. Second, bees make honey. Is honey sweet or salty? So the answer is honey is sweet. Okay, shahad is sweet, मतलब मीठा होता है, okay? And you have never tasted it, then ask your mom, okay? She'll give you. You taste it and see how is it? Is it sweet or salty? But the answer is the honey is sweet. Now, coming to the grammar part, we are going to study when do we use this and that, okay? There are few sentences which are given over there, given below, and we're going to solve them now. Remember that this, THIS, this is always used when there is a particular thing, object, or a person which is near to you, okay, which is near to you, that is when you use this. That, okay, is used when that particular object, place, okay, or person is far away from you. Okay, that is the time you use that in the sentence. Right? Over here, y'all can see the pink color arrow. I have drawn this arrow over here. The arrow, which is small, okay, shows and indicates that the places are near. The arrows, which are long or big, shows that the particular place is far. So it will become easy for you to understand whether to use this or that in the sentence. This is my house. Over here, you can see the house is near. Okay, that's why we have used this. In the second sentence, that is my house. So when your house is far, you're pointing it out. If you're far from your house, that is when you will use or say that is my house. This is my mom. If your mom is standing or sitting just right next to you, she is, you know, like in a closer proximity, she is near you. So then what you will use this is my mother. You will use that is my mother when your mom is standing far away from you. Okay, you're pointing it out and you're telling your friend or your, you know, someone, you know, your school teacher or someone, you're showing that, you know, there she's standing, right? So that is my mother near the gate. She's far away from you. That is when you use that. Now we are going to study the other grammar topic, that is one and many. One shows or says singular, which is just one, and many, meaning which is more than one. Okay, that also, you know, is called as plural. So one is singular, many is plural. One is just one, many is more than one. So over here, what we have to do is we have to add a for one and add s for more than one. Okay. In the first image, you can see trees. You can see that there is more than one tree. Okay, there are many trees over here. So you will add S, okay, behind in the end of the tree, T-R-E-E, tree. Okay, if at all it's just T-R-E, tree, it shows that it is just one tree. There is just one tree. But over here in the image, as you can see, there are many trees. That's why to make it plural or in a many form, you will add S at the end. Second image is, you can see there are various flowers over here in the bouquet. Okay, so it is more than one flower. There's more than one flower. So you will use S in the end. You will add S in the end and it will become flowers. Now, third image, you can see there's just one cat, which shows that it's singular, there's only one. So you will, what will you write? You will write a cat, okay, a cat. Now, next, the fourth image, you can see over here, there are various chicks, okay? There are three chicks, more than one, which again shows it's plural. So you will add what? You will add S in the end, so it will become C-H-I-C-K-S, chicks. If at all it was only one chick, then you would not add S. You will just write a chick. But as there are more than one, you're going to write chicks. Okay. Okay. Next, you can see houses. You can see there's more than one house. There are three houses. So you will add S in the end. It will become houses. Okay. So it will become in a plural form, houses. Next image, you can see there's a red color car. There's only one car, which shows that's only one. It's a singular form. So you will write a car. Next, you can see there are girls and boys. There are kids. They are playing on the swings. Okay, there are four swings over here and they are playing on the swings. So what it is, plural form again. So you're going to add S later on, so it will become swings, swings. You can see the last image over here that there's a person, a boy, okay, playing what cricket? And he has a bat in his hand. Do you play cricket with two, three bats in your hand? No, you just use one bat, right? So it's again singular, so it will become a bat. Let's enrich our word store. Okay, look at the each group. There are three groups given over here. Which word is different? Say why it is different. Okay, which object over here stands different from the others? We have to see that. And why is it different? We have to also mention that. So, first one you can see there's a table, there's a car, bed, and a chair. Which is an odd man out, odd one out? You can say car. Why? Because the other three remaining objects, except for the car, are the furniture. Okay, and car over here becomes a vehicle. So, car becomes an odd one out. Second one, there's a bun, a bag, a box, and a bottle. Right? So, over here, what is, an odd man out? A bun, okay? Becomes an odd man out, okay? Because the other three are the objects of keeping. You can keep a bag, you can keep a box, you can keep a bottle. You cannot keep a bun, you need to eat it. Okay, so it is an edible thing that you eat it, and the other things are just an object that you can keep. Third one is a goat, cow, tree, and horse. Over here, tree becomes an odd one out because the other three things are animals. Okay, the goat is an animal, cow is an animal, horse is an animal, tree is a plant. Okay, so tree will become an odd one out. Okay, write the names of these things below the pictures. Okay, you need to write it down. I have drawn the six images. You need to identify which one is what. The first one, can you identify it? It's a thing which you can wear it around your pants, a skirt. You usually wear it when you come to school. It is called as a belt. Correct. Second one is you use it every day in the morning when you go for your shower, to go when you go for your bath. That is soap. Third one is you again use it every day to eat your food. You have your lunch and dinner, your breakfast in it. It is a plate. Fourth one is a need, okay, that everybody has, which is an important thing that we need to, survive on. And it is what? There's a water. Okay, there's water, but the water is in what? In what do you drink water? You drink water in glass. So this is glass. Fifth one is again comb. You use it every day to comb your hair properly. Sixth, again, a thing which is used on a daily basis to sweep your house to keep it clean, and that is a broom. Okay. Write an, is, or are in the blank. First, we will study about the rules. When do we use an, is, or are? You use an when you're talking about yourself, like I am. Okay? When you use is, you use is when you are talking about a person or a thing, but which is in a singular form. What a singular form? Which is just one. That is when you use is. You use are when you're talking about something which is plural, meaning more than one, like two, three, or many of them. That is when you use are. And also you use are when there is a sentence which begins or starts with you. Okay, so let us solve few examples now. The bus is waiting. The bus over here is just one, right? It shows singular, so you will use is. If at all they had said the buses, okay, and if at all it had become plural, then you would use are. But over here in the sentence, it's just one plural singular, you will use is. The second sentence is three girls are in the bus. Okay, now three girls. Girls meaning plural. It's more than one. There are many. It's more than one. There are like three girls over here. So you will use are. Okay, A-R-E-R. Third one, two boys are getting on. Getting on meaning they're getting into the bus. So again, this is plural, more than one. Okay, there are two boys. So you will use A-R-E-R. Fourth one, the bus is going. The bus is going, meaning the bus is moving now. Okay, it's again one bus, so you will use is is. Fifth one, wait for me. A boy is running to the bus. Okay, a boy, a small boy. Okay, so again, boy is singular, one boy, so you will use is, meaning he's running and coming towards the bus because he wants to get in the bus. Sixth one, you are late, says the girl. Okay, the girls are saying that the girls are saying to the small boy that you are late. Okay, and as I said, what you will use before you, okay, what you will use when a sentence starts with you will use A-R-E-R. Seventh one, I am sorry, says the small boy. Okay, so he, because he's late, okay, what is he say, what is he telling to the girls? He's saying that I am sorry. So before I, what you use am. Okay, so I hope you have understood the whole chapter as well as the question answers and the grammar portion. If you haven't understood anything, if you have any doubt, please feel free to ask. And homework for today is you are going to write, copy down all the question answers and the grammar part and everything that you have come across and seen in the slide. You are going to practice to read the chapter. And the most important thing is, you know that we will only mark your attendance if at all you send your homework before 6 o'clock on WhatsApp. So please make sure that you write your name and send the homework along with your standard. Thank you for attending today's lecture. I hope you all have understood well. Stay home and stay safe. Thank you for attending today's lecture. Take care of yourself and the near ones and the dear ones of yours.